once knew a nigga whose real name was William. His primary concern was making a million, being the illest hustler that the world ever seen. He used to fuck movie stars and sniff coke in his dreams. A corrupted young mind at the age of 13. Nigga never had a father and his mom was a fiend. She put the pipe down, but for every year she was sober. Her son's heart simultaneously grew colder. He started hanging out, selling bags in the projects, checking the young chicks, looking for hit and run prospects. He was fascinated by material objects, but he understood money never bought respect. He built a reputation cause he could hustle and steal, but got locked once and didn't hesitate to squeal. So criminals he chilled with didn't think he was real. You see, me and niggas like this have never been equal. I don't project my insecurities on other people. He fiended for props like addicts with pipes and needles, and so he felt he had to prove to everyone he was evil. A feeble-minded young man with infinite potential, the product of a ghetto-bred capitalistic mental. Coincidentally, dropped out of school to sell weed, dancing with the devil, smoked until his eyes would bleed. But he was sick of selling trees and gave in to his greed. Everyone trying to be trife, never faced the consequences. You probably only did a month for minor offenses. Ask a nigga doing life if he had another chance, but then again, there's always the wicked that knew in advance. Dance forever with the devil on a cold cell block, but that's what happens when you rape, murder, and sell rock. Devils used to be gods, angels that fell from the top. There's no diversity because we're burning in the melting pot. So Billy started robbing niggas anything he could do, get his respect back in the eyes of his crew. Starting fights over little shit up on the block, stepped up to selling mothers and brothers the crack rock. Working overtime, making money for the crack spot. Hit the jackpot and wanted to move up to cocaine, fulfilling the Scarface fantasy stuck in his brain. Tired of the block niggas treating him the same. He wanted to be major like the cutthroats and the thugs, but when he tried to step to him, niggas showed him no love. They told him any motherfucking coward can sell drugs, any bitch nigga with a gun can bust slugs, any nigga with a red shirt can front like a blood. Even Puffy smoked the motherfucker up in the club, but only a real thug can stab someone till they die, standing in front of them, staring straight into their eyes. Billy realized that these men were well guarded, and they wanted to test him before business started. Suggested raping a bitch to prove he was cold-hearted. So now he had a choice between going back to his life or making money with made men. Up in the sight, his dreams about cars and ice made him agree. A hardcore nigga is all he ever wanted to be, and so he met them Friday night at 2:45. Everyone trying to be trife, never face the consequences. You probably only did a month for minor offenses. Ask a nigga doing life if he had another chance, but then again, there's always the wicked that knew in advance. Dance forever with the devil on a cold cell block, but that's what happens when you rape, murder, and sell rock. Devils used to be gods, angels that fell from the top. There's no diversity because we're burning in the melting pot. They drove around the project slow while it was raining, smoking blunts, drinking, and joking for entertainment, until they saw a woman on the street walking alone, 3 a.m, coming back from work on the way home. And so they quietly got out the car and followed her, walking through the projects. The darkness swallowed her. They wrapped a shirt around their head and knocked her onto the floor. This is it, kid, now you got your chance to be raw. So Billy yoked her up and grabbed the chick by the hair and dragged her into a lobby that had nobody there. She struggled hard, but they forced her to go up the stairs. They got to the roof and then held her down on the ground, screaming, "Shut the fuck up and stop moving around." The shirt covered her face, but she screamed and clawed. So Billy stomped on the bitch till he broke in her jaw. Them dirty bastards knew exactly what they were doing. They kicked her until they cracked her ribs and she stopped moving. Blood leaking through the cloth, she cried silently. And then they all proceeded to rape her violently. Billy was made to go first, but each of them took a turn, ripping her up and choking her until her throat burned. A broken jaw mumbled for God, but they weren't concerned. When they were done and she was lying bloody, broken and bruised, one of them niggas pulled out a brand new 22. They told him that she was a witness for what she'd gone through, and if he killed her, he was guaranteed a spot in the crew. He thought about it for a minute, she was practically dead, and so he leaned over and put the gun right to her head. Before he pulled the trigger and ended a life, he thought about the cocaine with the platinum and ice, and he felt strong standing along with his new brothers. Cocked the gat to her head and pulled back the shirt cover, but what he saw made him start to cringe and stutter, cause he was staring into the eyes of his own mother. She looked back at him and cried cause he had forsaken her. She cried more painfully. And when they were raping her, his whole world stopped. He couldn't even contemplate. His corruption had successfully changed his fate. And he remembered how his mom used to come home late, working hard for nothing, cause now what was he worth? He turned away from the woman that had once given him birth, and crying out to the sky cause he was lonely and scared. But only the devil responded, cause God wasn't there. And right then he knew what it was to be empty and cold, and so he jumped off the roof and died with no soul. They say death takes you to a better place, but I doubt it. After that they killed his mother and never spoke about it. And listen, cause the story that I'm telling is true, cause I was there with Billy Jacobs and I raped his mom too. And now the devil follows me everywhere that I go. In fact, I'm sure he's standing among one of you at my shows. In every street cypher listening to Little Thug's flow, he could be standing right next to you and you wouldn't know. The devil grows inside the hearts of the selfish and wicked. White, brown, yellow and black color is not restricted. You have a self-destructive destiny when you're inflicted, and you'll be one of God's children that fell from the top. There's no diversity because we're burning in the melting pot. So when the devil wants to dance with you, you better say never, because a dance with the devil might last you forever.